morning, Professor D here. I'm so glad you came to join me again with Your Choice. Today what we're going to be preparing is some almond milk. And then from the almond milk we're going to make a smoothie. It's all natural, totally good for you. First of all, what do almonds have in them that are so good for you? A raw almond is like a powerhouse. Almonds have protein, good kind of protein. It's rich in calcium, and it also has what we call vitamin B17, which is laetrile. Years ago, a friend told me, you know, Dee, if you eat 10 almonds a day, you'll never come down with cancer. And I thought, what? What is she talking about? I never knew until years later when I worked for a doctor who actually put people on, like, almonds and different types of natural foods, that this has laetrile in it, and cancer does not like laetrile at all. It does not like raw almonds. When you cook the almond, you lose the enzymes. Enzymes are very, very important, as we've mentioned before. All right, what we're going to do, now I'm just going to take a handful of almonds and put in the blender, and we'll make it two handfuls. You will measure out maybe, let's say, a cup of raw almonds. Now, the blender you get is very, very important. This is an Osterizer. It's a super good blender. But it's not just a regular Osterizer. It's one that will also chop ice. It's not a real expensive blender, but it's a blender that does the job, and it does a super good job. All right, if you were going to measure this out, I would say like 1 cup of almonds. And then we would add like a cup of water. I'm going to guesstimate this. We're going to just kind of cover it. And then what we're going to do is we're going to blend it. Blended it. We're going to add a little water. I want you to look at the consistency of this. It's kind of like a paste. And what we need to do is make it much thinner. Now before I do add that, if you want to add a little sweetener, agave is very, very good. Or you can add, let's say, dates. The DiGiorgio dates are super good for you, packed with iron and packed with different types of minerals. Okay, I'm just going to pour a little bit of agave in here to give it a little sweetener. And then I'm going to add a little bit of vanilla. Now, if you were going to do a sure measure exactly how much it was, I would say maybe like a teaspoon of vanilla and maybe 2 to 4 tablespoons of agave. But then we're going to add more water. Now, the reason you don't add all the water in the beginning is that the almonds will not blend real good. So whenever you're blending nuts, add just a little bit of water, blend them good, then add more. Okay, now we're going to blend this. Okay, and now we have our almond milk. It smells good. And we can pour it in a cup. And I forgot a cup. Just pour it in your cup. Now you, and notice how white it is. Now if you want it whiter than what it is now, and all this is almonds with water, vanilla, and agave. And what is agave? You say, well, what on earth is that? Agave, it comes from a plant. It's kind of like a cactus. It's a very natural sweetener. And then you can drink. Or you can put it on your cereal. But what we're going to do now is we're going to make a smoothie. And to make this smoothie, what I have done, I have taken ripe bananas. Now, what's the difference between a ripe banana and an unripe banana? A ripe banana has what they call sugar spots. That means the starch is turned to sugar and it's readily digestible. And you want them digestible. These here are not ripe yet. They do not have the spots on them. They do not have the sugar spots. All right, we're going to take a little bit more of... No, I think we can use it like it is. We're going to add blueberries. We'll just dump some good blueberries in there. And these are frozen blueberries. I find if I freeze my fruit, that they make a better smoothie. And I've also frozen the bananas. You can just put them in there. You can break them up a little bit. What are bananas good in? They're good in a lot of different things, but what are they good for your body? And how is it good for your body? How is it good for your body? Potassium, energy. One banana actually gives you enough aerobic energy that you can aerobically exercise for 2 hours. And if you don't believe me, try it. It works. It works beautifully. Okay, we're going to add several bananas here. We're going to make a really good smoothie. And folks, this has no dairy at all. It's just totally natural and totally good for you. Then we're going to put the top on. Try not to make too big of a mess. I might have a little too many in there right now. We'll see. There we go. And watch your ears. Now, something you can do too, if you feel that you're not getting stirred up enough, use a spoon. Just stir it up a little bit and then blend it a little bit more. Now you can add strawberries, you can use pineapple, all kinds of good things. Blueberries, oh, blueberries are like the king of berries. They are so good for us. Full of they're super good for you. Okay, we're going to stir it up a little bit. Antioxidants. Alright, here we go. Now we're ready to drink. This is a nice, healthy drink. You can serve this to your family and feel great about it because it's super good for you, packed. You want a protein drink? This is the protein drink that your body will simulate.